Hey guys, it's Megan. So I've been drawing and making art consistently for about a year and a half now. And in that time, I've had the opportunity to experiment with quite a few different supplies. I know that it can be a little confusing to figure out exactly what you need when you're first starting out. So I thought it would be fun to make a list of my top 10 art supplies for beginners. And just as a disclaimer, you definitely don't need everything on this list. Really, the only thing you need to make art is a pencil and paper. These are just my favorite mediums, but there are plenty of other options out there. So with all that being said, let's just get into the video. The sketchbook I currently use is the Arteza 5.5 by 8.5 inch mixed media pad. I've tried out a bunch of different sketchbooks, but I really like the inexpensive spiral-bound ones. My old sketchbook was a Canson mixed media one, and it was the same size, and these are pretty comparable to each other. Since it's spiral-bound, it can lay flat, which I really like, and it's the perfect size. Not too small, but it's not so big that the pages are intimidating. I don't use anything fancy to sketch, just a Ticonderoga number 2 pencil. And the only reason that I use these is because it's my dad's favorite type of pencil, so we just always have them in the house, and yeah, so now it's my favorite pencil too. My favorite type of eraser are these Pentel high polymer ones. You can get these at the dollar store. I also have a kneaded eraser, which I low-key bought just because all the art YouTubers said, like, that I needed one, honestly. And they weren't wrong. You know, it's nice when you want to partially erase a sketch, and I forget what brand it is, but I think I got it at Hobby Lobby for like $2 or $3. Something that I find myself reaching for surprisingly often is the Statler Circle Stencil. This is another thing that I may or may not have stole from my dad, but I've had it for like 2 years and he hasn't noticed that I took it, so he obviously doesn't miss it. When I need to draw larger circles, I use lids from various old jars. I use this blue one actually a lot, surprisingly. I generally start my drawings in one of three ways. Either I'll sketch the whole thing with a pencil, or I'll just sketch guidelines for a simple pen doodle. For paintings, a lot of times I won't sketch anything out, but it depends on what I'm painting. I use Micron pens to outline my sketches. I bought a set that came with a bunch of different sizes on Amazon, but the size that I use most is size 03. To add highlights on my drawings, I like to use these Uniball Signo white gel pens. There are quite a few white gel pens out there, but this is the best one that I've tried. For markers, my favorites would have to be the Ohuhu brush markers and the Winsor & Newton Pro markers. I really like the brush tip on the Ohuhu markers, and that the cap can be stuck on the opposite end while you're drawing. The Winsor & Newton markers fill in the colors that I don't have for the Ohuhu set. I have a set of skin tones and a set of cool grays that I tend to use a lot. I haven't been doing this as often lately, but when I want to do a more realistic drawing, I like to use Prismacolor colored pencils to add shading over the markers. And these are ridiculously expensive at Michael's or like any craft store. Seriously, do not buy them there. They put them on sale on Amazon all the time. I got this set of 72 for around $35 and a set of 24 for around $12. If Prismacolors are a bit out of your price range, I really like these Crayola twistable colored pencils as well. They're great because you don't have to sharpen them, and they rarely break like traditional colored pencils. When I use colored pencils, I like to seal them in with matte Mod Podge. I learned this trick from Mariah Elizabeth in her Create This Book series, and it's one of my favorite hacks to use. Which, by the way, I didn't forget about my Create This Book. I'm just not sure if like YouTube will allow it with all of their new changes coming, since I'm not sure if they'll consider that like a kid's video, because they've really been unclear about that so far, so I guess we'll see when January comes if like all my videos get demonetized, but if they don't, then I'll finish my Create This Book. The most used supply in my whole entire craft room probably has to be Posca pens. These paint pens are such a versatile supply, and they were definitely worth the investment. Posca pens come in quite a few different sizes, but the ones that I have are extra fine, fine, and medium tipped ones. It depends on what you intend to use them for, but if you don't want to invest in multiple sizes, I definitely recommend getting the fine tip set. I probably use the extra fine tip set more, but the fine tip pens have larger barrels and they hold more ink. And your line width can be varied depending on how hard you press down when you draw. Since these are a bit more expensive, I really only use them to add small details. For larger areas, it makes more sense for me to use acrylic paint. I have a few different types of paint that I use. For backgrounds, I typically use the cheaper craft paint from Walmart or Michaels. For the foreground, I use Arteza acrylic paint. I really like this set of 60 paints that I have. It's fairly inexpensive and comes with a wide variety of colors. Which I know, technically, you could just get some larger tubes of the primary colors, black and white, and just mix the colors as you need them. But honestly, I'm just lazy and I kind of hate mixing paint. So what I've been doing is when I run out of a color in the Arteza set, I'll either buy a larger Arteza one or a tube of Liquitex Basics paint. I've gone through a few larger tubes of white so far, and I bought a larger version of the color Mauve Pale from Arteza. Something that I've found surprisingly useful is this golden acrylic paint retarder. You can add this to your paint to slow down the drying time, which is great if you want to do a Bob Ross style painting with acrylics. I've also used it to sort of rehydrate paint that's been left sitting out for a while. I've been challenging myself to use the front and back of each page in my sketchbook, which I'm almost done with it, by the way, so expect a new tour soon. But since I use alcohol-based markers and they bleed through to the other side of the page, I've either been covering it up with a collage or I'll do a painting on the back. To make sure that the marker doesn't show through the paint, I like to cover the back of the page with a thin layer of Liquitex Basics acrylic gesso. Notice I said thin layer. I put a little bit too much on this page and the gesso ended up cracking. I'm still working on figuring out how to squeeze out just the right amount of paint, but, you know, it's fine. Thankfully, I was able to hide it fairly well in the end, and it's just a sketchbook page, so I'm not too worried about it. The last art supply that I can't live without is a hairdryer. Now, I know that this probably isn't the first thing that pops into your mind when you think art supply, but buying an extra hairdryer to keep in my craft room was honestly one of the best decisions I've ever made. It was pretty cheap, too. It was only like $8 from Amazon. Which, if you notice a trend, yes, I really like Amazon. That's part of the reason that I do so many crafts with cardboard, which is probably my favorite craft supply. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see a video like this, but with my favorite craft supplies instead. That might be fun to do. So those are my top 10 favorite art supplies. Let me know in the comments what your favorite art supply is for a shout out in my next video. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe for more videos just like this one. Also make sure to follow me on Instagram and TikTok. They are both at WellerMegs. I also have a website, which you can find at www.meganweller.org. And yeah, I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!